मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, दिस इज द थर्ड लेक्चर ऑफ चैप्टर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी एंड द टॉपिक इज ओम्स लॉ। ओम्स लॉ इज द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस अक्रॉस अ कंडक्टर एंड द करंट फ्लोइंग थ्रू इट। वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन, डिफाइन ओम्स लॉ और स्टेट ओम्स लॉ और what do you mean by Ohm's law? You have to write, the current flowing through a conductor is directly proportional to the potential difference between its ends at constant temperature. Mathematically, current is directly proportional to potential, or potential is directly proportional to current. To remove this proportionality sign, we always use a constant. Therefore, V is equals to IR, where R is a constant. And this constant is called constant of resistance of a given metallic wire. In exams, you must find a question regarding how do you verify Ohm's law. For that verification, you are supposed to draw a diagram. Now, see here, AB is a resistor connected to a voltmeter, which is further connected to a battery and connected to key and connected to ammeter. What you must know, the sides or the potentials. Positive is connected to positive, negative is connected to negative. Here an arrow is designated with R. This means that this resistance is variable. Earlier I told you to draw the signs of the different components. Here you have written rheostat. So this is a sign for rheostat. Now, this setup of the circuit, which is shown earlier, it uses battery, it uses ammeter, it uses voltmeter, it uses nichrome wire AB. Then when we draw a graph between current and potential, the graph comes out to be a straight line. This shows that current is directly proportional to the potential across the ends. This is the graph. You must know the graph. The main question comes according to graph is, draw the graph for Ohm's law. Or How does the graph of Ohm's law will be seen? Or how do you represent the graph of Ohm's law? The answer for all the three questions are a straight line starting from the origin. The next topic is resistance. Resistance is the property of a conductor to resist the flow of current through it. Earlier, we had read about Ohm's law. Ohm's law states that V is directly proportional to I. Therefore, R is equals to V upon I, where R is the resistance, V is the voltage, I is the current. The SI unit for resistance is ohm. Very, very important question. Define 1 ohm. Answer to that question is, if the potential difference across the two ends of a wire is 1 volt and the current flowing through it is 1 ampere, then the resistance of a conductor is 1 ohm. I is equal to V by R. The current flowing through a resistor is inversely proportional to the resistance. Now, according to Ohm's law, R is equal to V upon I, or I is equal to V by R. From these equations, we must see that current is inversely proportional to R. If we are increasing current, R is decreasing. If we are increasing R, current is decreasing. If the resistance is doubled, current gets halved. In many practical cases, it is necessary to increase or decrease the current in an electric circuit. A component used to regulate current without changing the voltage source is called variable resistor. In the electric circuit, a device used rheostat is used to change the resistance in the circuit. So, the other name for the variable resistance is rheostat. And what is the function? Without changing voltage, we can change the current. We can increase or decrease the current. This is a very important question, and in this year also this question comes. Factors on which resistance of a conductor depends. The resistance of conductor depends upon two factors. First is length. Resistance is directly proportional to length. Remember this, directly. If we increase length, resistance will be increased. Smaller length, less resistance. Larger length, more resistance. The second is area of cross section. Area is inversely proportional to R. Less the area of cross section, that is thin wire, more is the resistance. More is the area of cross section, that is thick wire, less is the resistance. Thin wire, more resistance. Thick wire, less resistance. Now, the third is material of the conductor. From 1 and 2, it is clear that resistance is directly proportional to length, inversely proportional to area. R proportional L by A. To change this resistance inversely proportional sign, we used a constant called rho, where rho is the constant of proportionality called resistivity. This rho depends upon material of the conductor. The unit for resistivity, shift all the things here, you get R, rho is equal to R A by L. R is ohm, A is meter square, L is meter. Meter, meter cancels out. The unit for resistivity becomes ohm meter. Now, the main question comes, what is resistivity? Resistivity is the resistance offered by a conductor of 1 meter or to the flow of current across positive faces of the conductor. You must know very, very importantly, conductors like metal and alloy have low resistivity. Please remember this. Insulators have high resistivity. Material which have low resistivity are good conductor. Example, silver. Resistivity of substance depends upon the material from which substance is made up of. Please remember this. Conductors have low resistivity. Insulators have high resistivity. Very, very important question. Why alloys are used to make electric heating devices like electric iron, toaster, etc.? The resistivity of an alloy is generally higher than its constituent metals. Alloy do not oxide or it do not burn easily at high temperature. That is why they are used in electric heating devices. Tungsten is used most exclusively for filaments of electric bulb. Copper and aluminium are generally used for electric transmission of lines. Here is a chart showing the resistivity of some of the materials. You are not supposed to learn this, but go through this table once so that you know the difference between conductor, alloy and insulator according to the resistivity. Here are the four questions depending upon the resistivity. Try to solve these off. Send me the answers. And these are the questions from your NCERT. You are supposed to write the numerical questions and these resistivity questions in your copies. Rest, you may write or you may not write depending upon your condition. Tomorrow we'll start with the next topic. Here, till resistivity, we are over with. Thank you. Stay blessed. God bless you.